Alright, 3D artists, are you tired of spending hours trying to capture that perfect 3D model? You're not alone. Clients want more and they want it fast. But who has time for that? What if I told you there is a free app that can turn your phone into a powerful 3D scanner? Yes, I'm talking about Kiri Engine. In this video, I'm going to show you just how stupidly easy it is to create incredible 3D scans in minutes. We'll dive into the basics and then I will show you some advanced tricks to take your scanning game to the next level. So get ready to be blown away. Welcome back to Premier VFX, I'm your host Scott, and if you are hungry for more killer content like this, smash the like button, subscribe for more awesomeness, and let's dive in right now. Alright, you've probably heard of photogrammetry. It's the magic of turning real-world objects into detailed 3D models just by snapping photos. You take a bunch of shots from different angles, and boom, you've got a 3D model. The best part, it's super quick and insanely detailed. From tiny plants to massive cliffs, this technique captures everything with realistic textures that make your models pop. But enough talk. Let's dive in and start creating some killer 3D models. We are using an app called Kiri Engine. And guess what? It's totally free. Just download it from the Play Store for Android or the App Store for iOS. For today's photogrammetry demo, I'm using this badass action figure I own, Silk Spectre, the superheroine from Watchmen by DC Comics. Let's see if Kiri Engine can do her justice. When you open the app for the first time, you'll need to create an account. I've already done that, so let's jump in. Click the big plus button at the bottom. Select Photo Scan. This is where the photogrammetry magic happens. Then tap Take Photos and you're ready to roll. The key here, keep the object perfectly still while you move around it, capturing photos from every angle, top to bottom. Pro tip, instead of walking around the object, use a rotating turntable like this one I got from Amazon. It's super affordable and perfect for small to medium objects. Game changer. At the bottom, you'll see two options, manual capture or auto capture. I prefer manual, it gives you way more control over each shot. Up top, there's an option to toggle between auto and manual camera settings. Honestly, auto works perfectly fine for me, so I stick with that. Here's another tip. While Kiri Engine works in most lighting setups, a softbox light makes a big difference. It reduces harsh shadows and keeps your textures clean. Don't have a softbox? No problem. Just shoot near a window with soft indirect light. Place your object in the center, keep your phone steady, and rotate the turntable for each photo. Snap photos from all angles. Don't forget close-ups to nail those finer details. There's even a progress bar at the bottom to help you know if you need more shots for a good result. Super handy. Once you're done, hit the arrow button. Name your object. I'll call mine Action Figure. Check your photos for any blurry shots and delete them if needed. If you're using a turntable, turn on Auto Object Masking so the AI can properly isolate the object. Now, choose your settings. Polygon count, low, high, or ultra if you've got a pro account. Texture resolution, 1K to 8K. File format, FBX works great. Max out the settings, hit upload, and let Kiri Engine work its magic. And boom, here's the result. A crisp, clean 3D model ready to go. Spin it, zoom in, admire it. It's that good. In the top right corner, you'll find a crop tool to clean up your model. Adjust the rotation to align it perfectly in world space. You can also crop unwanted parts by selecting a plane and moving the slider up or down. Want to tweak the texture? The texture editor lets you adjust brightness, sharpness, saturation, and more. Once you're happy, hit save edit. But for now, let's move to the web version for more precise edits. Log into the Kiri Engine website, click My Models, and there's your scan. Click on it to edit, and you'll get even more control. Use Transform to adjust the rotation with precision. Use the crop tool to remove unwanted parts, just like on the phone. When you're done, hit finish. Now here's the cool part. Click Fill Holes to patch up any gaps in your model. Once it's processed, download your final model. And there you have it. This is hands down one of the easiest, fastest ways to 3D scan on a budget. The results are amazing and it takes just minutes to create. What do you guys think? Drop a comment and let me know.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I'll see you guys in the next video.